Saw that what are these three moods, what are these three colors? They are the Sattva, Rajas, Tamas, and their characteristics are of these. Sattva, being the pure, is luminous and wholesome. It binds him by attachment to happiness and by attachment to knowledge. So this is the symptom of Sattva, and this is what we saw last in the last class. And here the example, a person with sattvic quality or influence of sattva, when it is invoked, such a person becomes an expert in active worldly life, proficient in sacrificial lore, and his knowledge reaches the sky. He boasts that no one is as learned as himself, so much so that his mind has become like the sky, harboring the moon of sagacity. This quality of the sattva ties fetters in the form of happiness and knowledge and drags the helpless person like a bull. And now he goes on to the next verse. So we saw, in short, the feeling of holier than thou is the negative side of the sattva. So one must, being sattvic is good, but going beyond sattvic is fantastic. You need to go become sattvic if you want to overcome rajas and tamas. But having invoked sattva, purity and luminosity and knowledge, don't be happy with that. You have to go beyond knowledge. So here in sattva we are seeing two things. One is attachment to purity and attachment to knowledge. Two things. Now we are in the seventh verse. Seventh verse talks about the Rajoguna. Rajo ragatmakam vidhi. Rajo ragatmakam vidhi. Trishna sangasamudbhavam. Trishna sangasamudbhavam. Tanni badnati kaunteya. Tannibadnati kaunteya. Karma sangena dehinam. Know that rajas is of the nature of passion, born of desire and attachment. It binds fast a person, O son of Kunti, through attachment to action. So in the previous one also he said that he becomes an expert in active worldly life, isn't it? But what was that active worldly life? To do havan, yag, puja for the benefit of the society. Now it is no longer, a sattvic person cannot be selfish. Rajasic person can be selfish. So there we were seeing all these activities which were the result of purity. So automatically he gets the acumen to do more and more for the society. But what is his driving force there, the negative side of it, that he gets attached to doing good. That gives him the joy. It gives him joy to give lectures all the time. Why? Oh, it is good, it is sattvic. It is, I don't do yoga, I give lectures. You ask me anything, I can answer you. So, that arrogance is there, that I have the knowledge of everything. I can, what is sometimes we hear is that if you want me to be, you want to say Vedanta is fantastic, is the ultimate, yeah, I can speak about it. You want to say devotion is the ultimate, I can speak devotion is the ultimate. You want to say Karma Yoga is the ultimate, I can say Karma Yoga is the ultimate. You want to say all these are not there, I can speak about that also. So he feels that he is expert of everything. And that is the motivating force there. Whereas in Rajas, it is of the nature of lust, passion, and dynamism of desire. And from where is all this activity getting invoked? Out of desire and attachment. It binds fast a person, O son of Kunti, through attachment to action. So understand. What is the genesis? When we do not allow activity to happen, when we become the doer of action, that's when we precipitate vasanas. That's when we collect impressions. When we become the doer. And along with the doer, automatically the second aspect also comes, which is the enjoyer. Activity, actually speaking, activity is happening. By itself. Activity is happening by itself. This is how Mahatmas live. They do activity but without being the doer. What is the difference between Mahatma or a realized person? Us, we do activity with doership. We listen with hearership. We speak with speakership. So everywhere there is ownership of whatever activity is taking place, and that's where the infinite reality becomes as if caught up, ensnared, becomes identified because of this doership. And naturally this doership then precipitates impressions. Those impressions, when they erupt in the on the surface of the mind, they are called desires. So why we are having this life as an individual? Why are we having this life as an individual?
Because we are attached to all actions.
Because the prarabdha is expressing. And what is prarabdha?
Memories.
Impressions which have got manifested in this life is prarabdha. Vasanas which have manifested in this life or as this life is prarabdha. Because of that prarabdha, this body is there. Because of that prarabdha, these parents are there. Because of that prarabdha, you are in this country or whatever. All your conditions, all your experiences, everything is because of your prarabdha. But from where did that come? Someone else did not give you prarabdha. Okay, let's sprinkle him with bad prarabdha. Let's sprinkle her with good prarabdha. No. We only created our own destiny. And this is very important point. Anyway, so here, attachment to action brings about doership. Then that precipitates impressions. Impressions, some of them get released in the dream, some of them just wash away, but some of them stick. And what stick, they become the go into the vasana pool. So what Gyaneshwar Maharaj says, he rajayati karane jivate ranjau jane, he abhilakhate tarune sadachi ga, he zivi motake rige ani kamacha madi lage, मगवारया वळघे तूष्णेचिया घृते आबं आंबु खौनी आगयाळे वज्रार वज्राग्नीचे साधुकले आता बहु थेंकुले आहे तेथ तैसी खवळे चाड होय दुःखा सकट गोड इंद्र श्री ही सांकड गमो लागे तैसी तृष्णा वाढिनलिया मेरु ही हाता आलिया तर्हि म्हणे एखाद्या दारुणारळघो जीविताची कुरोडी वो वाळू लागे कवडी मानी तृणाची ये जोडी कृतकृत्यता. He says that it is called Rajas as it amuses the embodied self and keeps his desire for sensuous pleasures ever fresh. So what is that? What is that which is making, or the first expression of self-forgetfulness? You know, when we say avidya kama karma, so what is first one? Avidya. What is the next expression? Kam. Avidya is nescience, it is tamas. Kama is rajas. It's rajasic. So, the first thing that happens when we forget ourselves, what is that which happens? Tell me, I'm asking. What is the first thing that happens? Huh?
I'm in the body.
Before that, before I am the body, what happens when we forget ourselves? Mind comes into play. And what is mind? I thought, a play between I thought and that thought. Understand? So, mind is where duality expresses. If there is no mind, there is no duality. Mind's, the code for the mind is there should be two in order for mind to exist. So what are the first two that come about? I thought and that thought. And that are many. And the I, which was absolutely happy and contented with itself, now it has forgotten its own essential nature. So now it seeks contentment with something, with that, with something outside. So when they say tattvamasi, they say you replace all that with that, with absolute that. So anyway, so here he says that it is called Rajas, as it amuses the embodied self and keeps his desire for sensuous pleasures ever fresh. It is this Rajas which is making the mind continuously have the commentary. If there is no one to talk to, we are talking with ourselves, isn't it? That's the amusement that they are talking about. Continuously, if there is, oh, why the clock is black color, why don't they have the white color clock? It is much holier than black. Bolne ko kya hai na? Why this color of curtain? Why anything? They only have this cup or what, you know? But it cannot, it abhors rajas, abhors silence. Height of sattva loves silence. Rajas, it tell it to be silent. Nowadays kids say, no, I can speak to the wall. That is what it is. Keep the chattering keeps going on and 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 on. That is the quality of the rajas. Even if it gets a little access to the mind, it makes him run after sense objects, and then the embodied self rides on the wind of passion. Huh? When you get up in the morning, the moment you get up, is the world in your mind? Are the projects in your mind? Is the job in your mind? Are the patients in your mind? Are the clients in your mind? Is the breakfast in your mind? Nothing. Your mind is empty the moment you wake up. And then the mind is taken over by rajas, because when you wake up, it is sattvic. And then slowly, as stimuli start coming in, rajas takes hold. And it makes the mind to run after the world again. And the whole day, from morning till night, till we don't get into the bed, we are running after the world only. you. And in this way, running after the world means running away from the self, running away from the divine. And this is the quality of rajas. Then just as a sacrificial fire blazes forth when fed with ghee and burns all things great and small, so his desire becomes inordinate and even painful things seem pleasurable to him. See, what happens here is, and once this mind takes you outwards, and then once it locks onto something, whether it is a car, whether it is a person, whether it is a situation, whether it is some imagination, see, schizophrenia and all, it is all thought locking, thought fixation. We are also getting thought locked. That I am a man, that I am a doctor, that I am a Swami, that I am a speaker, that I know Vedanta, that I am a sattvic person, or I am doing good to other people, I am not a bad person. If 10 people come and praise you cook good, I am a good cook. It goes on. Our definition of ourselves is based on these thoughts which we have got attached to. Getting attached to thought is thought locking, thought fixation. And that brings about attachment. And what does attachment do? Attachment precipitates a impression in the mind, and then that at the appropriate time again expresses as desire, and when that desire expresses, depending upon the intensity, it propels the person, the embodied self, along with the body to go out and procure it. And in this way it gets lost in the, and then you know, those people, you must have been guilty of this. Sometimes you are watching TV and eyes are closing, but you want to watch the serial or the movie. And for some time, then someone comes around and says, "Hey, the movie is already over. What are you sitting here? What are you watching now?" "Oh, is it? I didn't see the ending." Isn't it? It has happened. It has happened to all of us. This is what is attachment. Go to bed and sleep. But this is, I'm giving you example of movie. Same thing happens to people. Same thing happens with relationships. Same thing happens with objects of the world. Same thing happens with our ideas. Same thing happens with our default settings which come out of our mouth as responses. This is all because of attachment. Otherwise, you have got infinite ways of expressing. Why only that particular way? Because you have decided this type of response defines me, isn't it? So we have put a shell around us. This is the way I am. Accept me as I am, otherwise go take a hike, you know. This is who I am. No, you are not that. But rajas doesn't allow you to go in that direction. Rajas keeps you involved in imagination, projection, activity. Here the example given is, just as the sacrificial fire blazes forth when fed with ghee. What is the ghee for this fire of desire? More variety, more stimuli. That is why you see, from stage dramas to black and white movies, to color movies, and now virtual movies. Because the experience is becoming closer and closer. It's becoming more refined. Not in the positive sense. And in this way, and burns up all great things, and when desire, the fire of desire, when it becomes lust for something, for name, fame, ambition, at any cost we are going to get there, then you forget all the rules of the game. It's about me. How do I get there? Then we burn everything along the way. Because we are not able to think. We are not able to discriminate. When the rajas has taken over, we are not able to discriminate. And if our desire is not getting satisfied, it will lead to anger. If it gets satisfied, it leads to greed. And then verse in second chapter, then greed also cannot be satisfied permanently, so eventually it leads to anger. Angry person becomes delusional, he loses the lack, he doesn't have discriminatory power, and when a person does not know what is right and wrong, that is his demise. He becomes broken. And this is the journey. So as long as rajas is guided by sattvic qualities, I don't know if that is what they have taken. That will come afterwards. I'll explain when it comes. And burns all things great and small, so his desire becomes inordinate, and even painful things seem to be pleasurable to him. Then even if he acquires the wealth of the God of heaven, he considers it too little. In this way, when his passion grows strong, he is not satisfied even if the Meru mountain falls in his hands, and he craves for bigger things. He is willing to sacrifice his life even for a two penny coin, and feels happy if he secures even a blade of grass. This was the story of Ravana. There is a Ravana within each one of us, the ten-headed demon. Anger, greed, jealousy, envy, arrogance. So beware. It is best. One must be dynamic, but that dynamism should be guided by sattvic mind. So if it is pure rajas, it will destroy you. You will become suicidal eventually. Depressed. But when it is guided by sattva, such people become great leaders. Till where we did? 166th verse. Aji asate vechizela paripahe kaya kizela. की जेल ऐसा पांगी वडील व्यवसाय मांडी मणे स्वर्गा हन जावे तरी काय तेथे खावे या लागी धावे याग करू व्रता पाठी व्रते आचरे इष्टापूर्ते काम्या वाचूनी हाते शिवणे नाही पै ग्रीष्मांतीचा वारा विसावो नेणे वीरा तैसा न म्हणे व्यापारा रात्र दिवस काय चंचळू मासा कामिनी कटाक्षु जैसा लवला हो तैसा विजूही नाही. He says he feels anxious as to how he will fare when all his wealth is exhausted, and expands his business with great zeal. Their question is only about survival. Whereas a sattvic person, what has happened to him? Is he not into survival? Positively speaking, yes. Negatively speaking, he is holier than thou attitude. But positively speaking, he abandons himself at the mercy of nature. He only thinks of the divine. Just like this fellow was only thinking of the year 12 exams. Year 12, right? Over.
Starting this year. Next year.
You are in year 11 now. Oh, okay. I said too quickly. But now for 2 years he is focusing only on year 12. See? Can't think of anything else. He will make sure day, night. Mummy will say, before she used to say study, now for next year she will say take a break son, go for a walk, watch some movie, enough of studies. No, you go for outside, I am going to study. Focused. So he feels anxious as to how he will fare when all his wealth is exhausted. Such people are living for survival. They want to, what do you call that word? And when is it enough? When is enough wealth enough? When is 2 houses, 3 houses, when is 200,000, 300,000 enough for a person? Who is on the streets, you go to Melbourne streets, if they get $2, $3, a soup kitchen, that is enough for them. Because no goal in front of them. See? But for a rajasic person, he becomes, it's like an intoxication of more. He will get exhausted, but he will not. He will never feel, the word was security, he will never feel secure even if he has everything. That is his problem. He begins to worry as to what he will live on in heaven, and so he undertakes sacrifices, observes vows after vows, builds wells, tanks, etc., and performs only rites which bear fruit, just as the wind blows continuously without respite in the last month of summer. He labors hard day and night in his business. The movements of fish or the side glances of a beautiful maiden are fickle, and the lightning is more fickle than them. But all these three are not fit to hold a candle to the rajas quality. So what is he doing it for? More and more power. More, he wants, he's not happy with being the emperor of the earth. He wants to be the emperor of the heaven. He wants the lordship of the divine world, not divine in the sense of, but where there is a result. In divinity, there is no result. In divinity, there is no result. In spirituality, when I say divinity, in spirituality, there is no result to be accrued. You have to lose everything. But till 2 steps below, you can keep gaining. Bhur bhuva svatava jana maha satyam. Till Brahmalok, you can keep acquiring. So here he says, the three examples, the movement of a fish, or the side glances of a beautiful girl, or the third most strong, even the lightning, they are not able to deviate him from his pursuit. And what is the pursuit? To become secure. See, what is the difference between this fellow and the sattvic fellow? The sattvic fellow is looking for security in divine. And because sometimes he loses the way, his intention is correct, but sometimes he becomes full of himself. But here, he is looking for security through the world, not through the divine. He is looking through the world. So he surrounds himself with people, he surrounds himself with houses, he surrounds himself with money. There's no end to it. Then after money, houses, then security cameras. Then he carries credit cards. Then the moment new technology comes, then he puts the credit cards in the RFID card pouch so that nobody should take away, steal his money out of his card. This is Rajas. But all these three are not able to hold a candle to the Rajas quality. It is not able to distract the person from his pursuit. Then, te tuleni gavege swarga sansara pange agi mazirige kriyanchiye aisa dehi deha vegala le trushne tsya sankhala khata topu vahe gala vyaparacha he rajogunache daruna dehi dehi asi bandhana parisa ata vindana tamachete. He says, one leaps into the fire of activity with great haste in the hope of securing sensuous enjoyments in this world or heaven. Thus the embodied self, even though separate from the body, is bound by the fetters of desires and becomes involved in various business deals. See, in the before we came into this, what did we explain? The kshetrajna is separate to the kshetra. The embodied conscious entity is separate to the embody of the field, that is the conditionings, the limitations. Limitations are inert. Body is inert. And mind is rajasic or sattvic, or it can be tamasic also. But the self, it is independent of this. The self is not sattvic, rajasic, tamasic. But very quickly we make a statement. Hey, I think this fellow is a very rajasic person. Oh, this fellow is a very tamasic person. If you see some person at the temple 3-4 times sitting meditation or chanting there, you'll say, oh, he is a very sattvic person. But you go and ask his wife, oh, he's a rakshasa. Isn't it? It's a different... But this is how we form opinion. So one leaps into the fire of activity with great haste in the hope of securing sensuous enjoyments. What are sensuous enjoyments for us? Wonderful clothes for the skin. We want to travel the world. Why? Enjoyment for the eyes. I've seen this, I've seen that, I've seen China, I've seen the beautiful everything. We want the latest music, the latest movie, the latest ragas. If some great singer has, I got a signed copy, you know, for myself. CD copy. He gave it to me himself, from his hands. Thus the embodied, but this self, this embodied self, because now this Atma, that is this life principle which is expressing through this body, through this equipment, and the quality of this equipment, gross body, subtle body, causal body, they can be tamasic, rajasic or sattvic. When it gets influenced by the rajasic activity or tamasic activity this fellow who was actually the illuminator, who was actually the knower of the field, starts taking the field to be I. Then he stops seeing that this is the body through which I am functioning. No, then what is, I am the body. But this I am the body is only an imagination. It's only a projection. It has never happened. I am thinking, this has never happened. I can never think. I can only illuminate. Understand what I am saying? But this imaginary idea that I am thinking, I am waking, I am sleeping, I am dreaming, I am a doer or I am a seer, this has never happened. But because of the strength of the thoughts, which are of the quality of Sattva, Rajas or Tamas, they then get influenced. They influence the embodied self. And if he gives them attention, he is gone. If he remains aloof and keeps, Aja, what's next, then no problem. Yeah, that was a lottery number which came. Five numbers out of the six were revealed to me. I'm waiting for the sixth one. When it is coming? Next life. It's all projection. You gave value to it. Then you get attached to those five numbers. You remember it more than your relationships because you're caught up in that. Thus the embodied self, even though separate from the body, is bound to the fetters of desires and becomes involved in various business deals. In this way, he is bound by the strong fetters of the Rajas quality. And now I shall tell you the characteristics of the Tamas quality. Tamas. So, previously we saw how attachment to knowledge and attachment to joy and happiness, when these are the two things we give attention to and get identified with them, that is how Sattva expresses. When we give attention and value to, desires for things of the world, objects of the world, stimuli of the world, security of this body, for satisfaction of this body. So you know sugar is not good for you, but you are not able to give up sugar in your tea and coffee. You know it is bad. You know it is going increasing every time you go to the doctor, but you are not ready to give up the sugar and change the diet. Why? Attachment. Same thing, people in the outside world, they get attached. How do I say? Anyway, let it be. Now to the 8th verse. Tamastvajnanajam viddhi mohanam sarvadehinam pramadalasya nidrabihi Tannibadnati Bharat. But know that tamas born of ignorance deludes all persons. It binds them, O descendant of Bharata, by inattention, sloth and sleep, nidra, alasya and pramad. So these are the three ways. Ajnanajam Vidhi. How does tamas express? The first expression of it is ignorance, ajnanajam, and where does it express? In all the bodies, all the people. And what are its characteristics? How do you recognize? By inadvertence, laziness and sleep. Vyavaharatse hi dole mandazene padale moharatri tse kale mehudeze agnana tse ziale jaya eka lagale zene vishwa bhulale natsata ase. He says, That, O Partha, is known as the tamas quality, which acts like a veil and dims the vision of common sense and is like a cloudy sky on the night of infatuation. It grows with ignorance and deludes the universe and makes it dance round its finger. So what is this ignorance? Is there anything called ignorance? According to Gyaneshwari Maharaj, there is nothing called ignorance. And his definition of ignorance is incomplete knowledge. So what is incomplete knowledge about? About yourself. That's the first place. What is the second place? About the Lord. Third place, about the world. Jeev, Jagat, Ishwara. This is what our world is. Wherever we are existing right now, as a body, for us these three are Jeev, I am an individual in this big universe, and there is some intelligent principle. I don't know. I am saying intelligent principle. Someone says, we don't know who made the creation, from where it has come. Something is there. So who is that? Some power, some force. So, incomplete knowledge about the world. What do I see in the world? I see people. I see objects. I see time. I see countries. But I'm not seeing space. I'm not seeing divinity in the world. So where is the fault? In the world? No. It's in my vision. When this clicks, that the fault is not in the world, fault is not in the God, I cannot change the God, I cannot understand it because he's beyond the mind, I cannot try to work out what the world is because it is too huge, I can't go through every aspect of the world. But where the fault is in my vision, then there may be possibility that I can change my vision if I change my convictions. If I change my knowledge, if I can transform myself, if scriptures are saying I am free and I am feeling I am identified, if I become free, maybe my knowledge will change about the world. I'll see the world differently. See, this is the journey. But, so this incomplete knowledge about myself, about the world and the Lord, is the effect of tamas. And what are its expressions?
But none of that is real.
None of this is real. When we use the word self-forgetfulness, where is it happening?
In the mind.
Correct? How you are communicating to yourself in the mind? Through thoughts. Thoughts are coming under which category?
Field.
You know that this thought came. You know that I am ignorant of what color cloth is behind me. I am ignorant of what is the height at which I am sitting. I am ignorant of when this body is going to stop manifesting life. I am ignorant of it at the moment. So am I ignorant? Or is the mind ignorant?
The mind is ignorant.
So as long as I am under the spell of the mind, but which mind? Tamasic mind. One of its expression is deep sleep. That is one of the nidra. But when I am awaking, how is it affecting me, the tamasic mind? Laziness, procrastination, repeating the same mistake again and again. And which is the mistake I am repeating again and again?
Forgetting the self.
Well said. So that's the main mistake I am committing again and again. Every satsang I come, I hear, I am the self, and the moment satsang gets over, I am the driver. I am the body. Now I have to go to sleep. Tomorrow I have to wake up. But satsang said, you are the one eternal, eternally illuminator. You can never go to sleep. You are always awake. But we very quickly we forget, and this forgetfulness, constant forgetfulness, is inadvertence. Repeating the same mistake again and again. Like when we go to a, what do you call, to a cremation, there we become so aware that one day our body is also going to go away. Man, you know, just now, day before yesterday, someone passed away. The daughter, you know, Nevgi? Nevgi went away. So they went to Vanuatu, mother and daughter. Daughter gave a present to her mother, surprise trip. Went into the water for snorkeling, only the daughter came out, wife, mother didn't come out. From one moment to the next. So, but when we become, when we hear this type of news, immediately we go, you know, Vedanta comes back. But very quickly, after 2-3 days, when the news becomes stale, becomes old, inadvertence. Again, we fall back into the old pattern of thinking. This is inadvertence. Which acts like a veil and dims the vision of common sense, and is like the cloudy sky of the night of infatuation. Everything is hazy. Two things. One is desires. They also make us, they do not allow us to think straight. And sleep also doesn't allow us to think straight. When our mind is influenced with tamas, that time also, when suddenly, you must have experienced sometimes in the afternoon, sudden tiredness takes over and you just you need a chocolate or you need a coffee or you need something to up yourself. That, what is that? That is tamas. You are not able to think straight. And in a general life also, if we are not, common sense will come only when we are focused on the self, not on the world. So here he says, where are we? 176th verse. अविवेक महामंत्र जे मौढ़ा मध्याचे पात्र हे असो मोहनास्त्र जीवांसी जे पार्थाते गातम रचुनी ऐसे वर्म चौखुरी देहात्म मानियाते हे एकाची खीर शरीरी माझो लागे चराचरी आणि तेथ दुसरी गोठी नाही सर्वेंद्रिया जाढ मना माझी मौढा मौढ्य मालहाती जे दाढ्य आलस्याचे आगे आंग मोडा मोडी कार्य जाती अनावडी नुसती परवडी जांभयांची. Symptoms is telling. It has thoughtlessness as its great mantra, mystical formula. Here, what is the word he has used? Aviveka Mahamantra. Aviveka, non-discrimination. Aviveka. And what is non-discrimination?
Self and
what is that non-discrimination? Inability to separate the permanent from the impermanent, changeless from the changing. That is discrimination. That is vivek. And here what it is now saying, it makes a person aviveki. His mantra is not being able to discriminate. What do such people say? Swamiji, all this is good when we listen, but it is very difficult. I try and it becomes aviveki. They don't want it. They only know how to complain. Nothing is difficult. They have gone through year 12, they have gone through PhDs, they have gone to medicine, they have gone through businesses, they have gone through the pain of losing near and dear ones. They have gone through migration and come and settled here. So many difficulties they have overcome. That time they did not say it is difficult. And even if they did, they did not allow that statement to influence their journey. But why do we succumb when it comes to spirituality? Very quickly we give up. It's easy. It's under the influence of tamas. Then all this complaining comes, that it is difficult, that I am not able to do it. It has thoughtlessness as its great mantra. It is a decanter filled with wine of ignorance. So, what is deep sleep state? Mind filled with no thought. Thought will be some material. When there is no thought, it is empty space. Mind filled with empty space. Here it is saying, it is filled, mind filled with the wine of ignorance. No thought is the tamasic state. Or a bewitching weapon which infatuates all beings. It's hypnotic. We want to be rid of the thoughts. If our thoughtlessness in the mind comes about as a result of self-contemplation, then it is healthy. Then it is healthy. But when we get addicted to only wanting an empty mind, then we will resort to drugs, we'll resort to alcohol, we'll resort to just vegetating on empty space, you know. Why? Then I don't have to discuss with anyone, I don't have to listen to anyone, I don't have to, live up to anyone. So all this is happening around us. Then I don't have to, no responsibility. Mind empty. Then what? This is the effect of tamas. It is like, it's a hypnotic trance. It's a hypnotic trance. Self-imposed hypnotic trance. You have not gone to a hypnotist. You have hypnotized, your mind has got hypnotized by itself. Not by anything else outside. Because everything is inside it only. So it has brought this condition upon itself. And what is that condition? Tamas. By such devices, it ties up those who regard their body as the self. So, what is that? What is it, sattva, rajas or tamas, which is making you feel that I am the body? It is the tamas. The tamas is overpowering. When it begins to grow up in all created things, it leaves no scope for others to grow. It blunts the organs, deludes the mind, and gives shelter to sloth. It makes the body slack, and one loses all enthusiasm for work and yawns every now and then. What is that? Yahan pe the word used is jumbha. Yeah? Where are we? Nusati parvadi zambhayanchi. Ek ke baad ek, yawn after yawn after. And what do we say? It happens to me also. It happens to all of us. But what is it? When we get tired, but we give the justification, I think there's less oxygen, I think I'm getting asthma, that's why I'm yawning. Or I got tired from morning till evening, I'm working, now it's time to sleep, so the yawn is coming. When too much food is in the stomach, yawn comes, isn't it? So when is the time that you don't yawn?
When you're in sleep.
True. But when you are inspired, when you are inspired, when you have a goal in front of you, then you don't, then there's no laziness. So in this way, tamasic state is where there is lack of enthusiasm for life. Lack of enthusiasm. They are like a, more or less like a vegetable. They have not become one yet, but they are in the, on way to becoming a vegetable. They vegetate on TV, they vegetate on food, they vegetate on laziness, they vegetate, अरे क्या करना है, what will I do if I become, everything God will provide, so I will not do anything. This is tamas. उघडियाची दिठी देखणे नाही किरीटी नाळवितांची उठी वो म्हणवनी पडलीये घोडी नेणे कानी मुरडी तयाची परी मुरकुडी उकलू नेणे पृथ्वी पाताळी जावो का आकाशही वीरो वरी येवो परी उठणे हा भावो उपजो नेणे उचितानुचित आघवे झांसुरता नाठवे जीवे जेथी चातेथ लवणावे ऐसी मेधा उभवनी करतळे पडिघाये कपोळे पायाचे शिरियाळे मांडू लागे. He says in the 180th verse. Such a person cannot see even when his eyes are open and gets up responding to a call, thinking that he heard someone. Just as a slab falls on one side and does not turn the other way, so he goes to sleep contracting his body. He does not turn over. He does not feel like getting up. Even if the earth sinks or the heaven falls. So, this is the height of going into tamas. Has it ever happened to you that you have slept and people have come and knocked the door and rung the bell and you have not got up? It has happened? Nahi happened. It happened to me. I used to go, my first job, I used to cycle 15 kilometers. And after 8 hours, 9 hours of job duty, then you cycle back 15 hours and then I used to go to sleep. It was night shift. So I used to come back at 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning, and once I touch the bed, I'm gone. And sometimes I used to be gone so long that in the afternoon, 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock, my sister used to come from school or the servant has come. They had to climb the terrace, jump into the balcony, then come and then I will awake. Then they will wake me up. I'm so gone. See? Because what is tired? Body is tired. And I have decided that I am the body. So I am exhausted, man. Tonight again I have to work. I have to take rest. And you go so deep into, go into sleep with body identification. Body itself is an expression of tamas. So when he goes to sleep contracting his body, he does not turn over, he does not feel like getting up, even if the earth sinks or heaven falls. No, I wouldn't have known. If someone had come and stolen, robbed the house, I wouldn't have come to know because I was dead to the world. When he feels sleepy, he does not recollect what is proper or improper, but only likes to remain in a reclining position. What is the way to sit? Way to sit is with a straight back. But wherever he sits in a reclining position. What is improper? One must be going to sleep also with alertness. One must sleep with alertness also. But here, is the cloth on you? Is the cloth or not on you? Are you? You have got no idea. He raises his hand to the forehead or sits with his head on the knees. When he is sitting on the chair or a table, and then they study. Or on the knee. Why? The body is getting tired. It continuously needs to give. He can't even carry his own head. He needs support. Give the support there. Then 185th. Ani nidre vishayi changu jivi athi lagu zhopi zata swargu vavo mane brahma yu hoize ma nizale yachi asize he vachuni duze vyasana nahi kavate zata voghe kalhata hi dola lage amruta hi parine ghe जरी नींद आली तेवीची आक्रोश बळे व्यापारे कोणे एके वेळे निघाले तरी आधळे आंधळे रोषे जैसे के धवा कैसे राहटावे कोणे सी काय बोलावे हे ठाकते की नागवे हे ही नेणे. He says he is so fond of sleep that he scorns heavenly bliss before it. He has no other vice except that he wishes to live as long as God Brahma is and pass it in slumber. That means he should be resting, everything should come to him. That is tamasic, not ready to move little bit also. If he trips down while walking, he goes to sleep on the road. वहीं पे लेट गया, गिर गया. Like day before yesterday, mom was sitting doing puja and we are just sorting some things out from the where the temple is kept. And because now we have taken the carpet and we have put floor like this, she just bent on the chair. And the chair moved up and slid away. On carpet it will not slide, but on the wood it has slid and she fell down. Now she fell down, she is so heavy. We tried so much, nobody at home. We couldn't bring her back on feet. Then she said, "Acha, now while I am on the floor, let's sort everything out." Sorted out. But I had my day exercise in that next 15-20 minutes to lift her up. Oh. Because she can't bend her knees now because of the pain. That if you fell down, sleep there. What will you do when I'm not here? She said, that is what he said. I'll go to sleep here till someone comes. And when he is sleepy, he refuses even a drink of nectar offered to him. If he is forced to work on occasions, he becomes blind with rage. This is all reactions. But it is the reaction because it is attached to laziness and sleep, that's why. He does not know how to behave, with whom to talk and what, and does not pause to think whether a thing will become available or not. Uncouth behavior, having no samskaras, how to speak with children, how to speak with teenagers, how to speak to elders, he's lost the plot. And then he says here, वनवामिया आघवा पांखे पुसोनी घेयावा पतंगुपा हावा घाली जेवी तैसावळ घे साहसा अकरणीच धिमसा किं बहुना ऐसा प्रमादुरुचे एवं निद्रालस्य प्रमादी तमहिया त्रिबंधी बांधे निरुपाधी चोखटाते जैसावन ही काष्टी भरे तैदिसे काष्टाकारे व्योम घटे आवरे ते घटाकाश नाना सरोवर भरले तय चंद्रत्व ते थे बिंबले तैसे गुणाभासी बांधले आत्मत्व गमे. He says, just as a moth jumps into fire foolishly thinking that it will put out its flame with its wings, so he ventures to do something which he ought not to do. In short, he likes to do stupid, careless mistakes. Thus, the tamas quality ties up the pure self with a triple bond of sleep, sloth, and heedlessness. So, what did we see? How does sattva bind the self? By attachment to knowledge and happiness. How does rajas bind the self? By desire, lust, and attachment to activity. And how does tamas bind the self? By sleep, procrastination, and inadvertence. These are the three. So, recognize, thou don't say, oh, I remember looking at you, I think this is rajas expressing out of you now. And this is tamas now. And you say, oh, I think tamas is coming now. While studying, how can tamas come? It is not to judge other people. It is to assess yourself. That are you inspired every moment? Is your focus on sattva, rajas, tamas? Or is your focus on the self? See, I went to this Ayurveda Shala in Coimbatore. Westerners were also there. Indians were also there. And every day there is a satsang with the doctor. Now that doctor has studied 30, 40 years and he's telling, even now I cannot tell you what sattva, rajas, tamas is. Meaning kapha, pitta and vata. It is an ongoing, lifelong study. It's only intuitive. But these fellows, youngsters who come there for 12 days, 20 days, suddenly they become experts at kapha, pitta and vata. And they are giving lectures, talking among themselves when they talk. You know, it is like this. This is an expression of when this disease comes or if this problem is there, it is kapha, this is pitta, this is vata. Don't give too much importance to sattva, rajas, tamas. And what is where we must give importance to? Yes, to the atma, to the divinity, to the immaculate self, to the knower of all the thoughts. Who is it? In whose presence are all these thoughts coming? Good, bad, ugly, knowledgeable. Who, from where? Who is knowing this body? Who is knowing the breath? Who is knowing the emotions? Who is knowing the convictions, decisions, I am. Who is this I? Come to this, find out who this I is. Is it the body I? Is it the breathing I? Is it the thinking I? Or is it some other I that I am, who is watching all these different eyes coming and going? Just like I can see the father I come, and immediately the father I becomes husband I, the moment wife comes in front, isn't it? You are knowing, but you feel I am the same, but my role has changed, and you unknowingly you start automatically play the next role. So this feeling that I am the same has been borrowed from the self. Self is changeless, so you don't feel that you have changed. But you are superimposing it on in all the roles. You are superimposing it on this body. You feel, I am the same body. No, but body has changed from childhood till today. It is not the same. Similarly, the sattva, rajas, tamas, waking, if you take it at a larger scale, waking, dream and deep sleep, they are changing continuously. Who knows it? I know it. Which I? Is it the waker I? Is it the dreamer I? Is it the deep sleep I? Or is it the eternal witness? And that I am. Maintain that poise. maintain that disposition. But for that, you have, the price that you have to pay for that is to be alert. And alertness not towards the world. Alertness towards this principle. Even while you are functioning in the world, moving around in the world, you cannot stop the thoughts from coming and going. You cannot stop the emotions from coming and going. You have programmed, the mind has programmed itself that in certain situations, default emotions are there. Default thoughts are there. Default responses are there. Default reactions are there, isn't it? Let them happen. You remain focused, attentive, poised in the self. And in this way, thus the tamas quality ties up the pure self with a top a triple bond of sleep, sloth and heedlessness. Just as the fire, while burning a piece of wood, appears to take its shape, or the sky takes the form of the earthen pot, or a lake full of water has the reflection of the moon, so the embodied self is bound by the fetters of the gunas and imagines through ignorance that he possesses their properties. So three examples again are given. Just like the space. Space starts thinking, oh, I'm bound, I need liberation from this hall, from this house. Space is always liberated. Wave is finding that it is bound and it's seeking liberation to be the water, but it's already the water. So what is the difference? If it is already water, why is it feeling bound? Because its attention is on its form, on its waveness. So if you are one of, you are the wave, in and through you only consciousness is there, then how do you shift this attention? Take your attention away from the form. Then where do you put your attention? Nitya, Shuddha, Buddha, Mukta, Swarupa, Satchidananda Swarupa. So bring your attention to such thoughts which do not precipitate in a form. Infinite does not precipitate, bring a form in your mind. Birthlessness does not bring a form in mind. Deathlessness does not bring a form in mind. most ancient does not give bring a form. Absolutely, nirmala, without impurity. When you think about these terms, these are pointers. No idea comes in the mind. You become empty. Only by replacing your attachment to the body, tamas, now you become attached to that which you do not know, but you are. But the only tool we have is the mind. So this reflected, just like the reflected moon in the waters feels that it is dancing on the water. Well, yeah, I don't want to dance, I don't want to break up into 1,000 pieces. The reflected moon is saying, because suddenly the wind picks up and the waves come. But has the reflection of the moon become the 1,000 pieces? There are 1,000 waves. But because it is identified with 1,000 waves, it feels it has become 1,000 times it has broken up. Same thing is our case. We have identified with zillions of thoughts, zillions of roles, zillions of positionings, or just 3, waker, dreamer, deep sleeper, the 3 main. And we are feeling, oh yeah, I need to realize, I need to get away from these 3. If you keep thinking about these 3, you will not be able to get away from these 3. You have to stop worrying about them. Let them come and go. You contemplate on the self. So just like that moon or the sun, which was ever unbroken, but the breakup was seeming as if on account of the waves. Similarly, this self is also never broken, but it seems broken up on account of all the thoughts, the sattva, rajas, tamas, with their own characteristics. This self gets enveloped by them, influenced by them, and feels as if it is broken up. Actually, it is never broken up. So recognize this about yourself. So this information of sattva, rajas, tamas is not given to assess others, to put others into a box, or to put yourself into a box. I think I am a sattvic. I still long time to go. Oh, I am rajasic. My God, so much more time to go. Tamasic, I don't think there is any hope for me in this life. We get all these statements. Now I am too old. I don't think it is possible now. And you tell them, Ma, you are already that. Nani, Swamiji, theek hai. See? Not to come down from that high position that we are. Remain there. For that, alertness is required. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Just sit quietly for 5-10 seconds.